Well, hello everyone and welcome to Walla Walla Whitman National Forest. I've made my way further into eastern Oregon and I'm here at the Woodward Campground on what appears to be a private lake in the U.S. National Forest that is Walla Walla Whitman. So a hot ride today, but it's much cooler today than it was yesterday. I say much, it's a high of 106 instead of 113, but it's rather cool up here in the high mountains. You'll see on today's road trip that I came through just a super flat, dry, beautiful, lovely rolling fields of wheat and hay, but felt like I was riding over a frying pan in the heat. And so got into a little town, I forget the name of it, and stopped at a gas station and gave Alice a drink, and then went inside just to relax and sit at a table and nurse a Diet Coke. And when I did that, I had a gentleman sit down next to me, and he had a duffel and a cowboy hat, and he just wanted to talk. And he told me that he's traveling on a Greyhound bus, and you know, so many of the people I meet on this trip have stories to tell. And the interesting thing is they just want to tell them. You know, they just want somebody to talk to. Maybe it's, you know, all the fallout of COVID and people not being able to visit one another. But I've met so many people who really just want to sit and chat a while and tell me a great deal about their lives. And so this fellow told me that, you know, he's on the way back from taking a bus from Lubbock, Texas to visit his sister. And he just sort of very much in passing mentioned my sister's dying, and he almost sort of ran past that line, and you know, it registered with me, and we went on to talk about a few other things, and I came out here and I said, did you tell me that your sister is dying? And he said, yes, she's dying of cancer down in Lubbock. And he told me he's 67 and she's 10 years older, and you know, he had a lot of details to share. He said, well, you know, I think she knew she had this and she didn't do anything about it, and he gave me some details about her physical condition. And you know, it just struck me that that's such a piece of humanity that we often overlook. You know, I'm very fond of the biblical verse that I believe from St. Paul, who said that we should always welcome strangers, for many have in that way entertained angels unawares. And I've met quite a few angels on this trip. The fellow who was camped next to me last night in Umatilla National Forest was very impressed with Alice, and you know, he came over and sat down and chatted and showed me all of the, you know, the various cars that he's, you know, antique cars, 57 cars, 1957, and you know, a 1957 Jeep, Willie Jeep, and that he's been restoring, and just, you know, chatted with me a long time about things that are important to him in his life. And you know, at various points in the conversation, he would say there was a period of incarceration, and he was trying to tell me that he'd been in prison. And I thought it was interesting that he felt the need to mention that. It was a bit sad for me because, you know, I certainly didn't judge him for what his past involved, but I thought it interesting that he felt the need to bring that up on a number of occasions. And he seemed a bit wounded to me, but just one of the nicest fellows. And he brightened up immediately when I mentioned Bonneville. And the speedway at Bonneville. Of course, he said he'd watched the movie with Anthony Hopkins, the world's fastest Indian, and was just ecstatic and so envious that I might get to go there and run that race course in Alice, such as she is, to be the world's fastest royal. So that is a plan still in the offing. I'm giving serious consideration to that. But it's just been another lovely day, as hot as it's been. And I meant to tell you about one other person I met who had a story to tell me. And that was a young man who sold me a milkshake and a few gallons of gas at some little town just about an hour from here in the middle of nowhere, Oregon. And he said, is that a Royal Enfield outside? And I have to tell you, I have this conversation probably 15 times a day with people who just want to talk about Alice. And this fellow said they were all over India. And I said, well, I imagine they were. This bike was made in India. And, of course, the Royal Enfield is famous throughout India. And he was just a young boy, but he said he lived in the in the Punjab region of India. And he said they call them bullets down there, which of course they do. That's a model of the Royal Enfield. And so I, you know, he told me, he stopped me several times before I left and said, "Sir, you have a beautiful bike." And so Alice is deserving of all the compliments she gets, and I'm just tickled to be able to ride her. And considering another journey, maybe throughout Europe for next spring. So stay tuned. I'll keep you posted about that. But for now, I'm just excited to see this American West. You know, I'm riding along, and I feel like I'm riding through every TV Western I've ever watched in my whole life. it's so beautiful and so dramatic, the landscape. So I'm a very lucky man to experience it. I'm very happy to share it with you, and God bless you for following my journey, and I will see you next time.